during afternoon class. Of course, I laid my head down on my desk and closed my eyes. Can't fall asleep. Inside, the pitch of blackness, confusion, uneasiness continues to grow. Suddenly I hear Ryu's voice. The teacher probably called on her. I can hear fluent English, though I haven't the slightest idea what's being said. Then why did just hearing your voice make my heart ache? Just for thinking about what I'm about to do from here on out, it feels as if tears are welling up in my eyes. I'm about to betray Ryu. Finally, school has come to an end. With the end of homeroom, people began to leave the classroom one by one. With bags still on my desk, I take my seat. Slowly, people begin to disappear. One by one, there are those who are leaving for the club activities, and there are those who are going home. Finally, only two people left in the classroom. Just me and Ryu. Now that we planned for this ahead of time, however, Ryu is waiting for me. She had been waiting for this. Guess I'll get started. Take a deep breath and press my hand against the desk surface. Then I stand up. Moya-kun. Right as I'm standing up, Ryu walks up to me. Looks at me with shaded depression within her eyes. She understands. She understands what's been bothering me. Understands what I'm about to say. Knowing that, she still stayed in the classroom up until now. Walked up to me. It's just the two of us, right? Says with a tone not unlike her usual. Yeah, that's right. This is making me feel a little nervous. And things like manga when there are only two people left in the classroom after class. That's when they do things like get kiss. Somebody might be watching us, so it makes me even more nervous. I must be saying something strange, right? Ryu. Says loudly as trying to stop me from speaking. Would you like to kiss? I am very nervous, but it calms me. Now that I realize that I'm right here next to you, Tomoe-kun calms me down. Even if I close my eyes, you're here next to me. The thing that right now is the very moment I'm closer to you than anyone else. It really relaxes me and calms me and makes me happy. Makes me even more nervous. Makes me feel happy. Ryu. What about you, Tomoe-kun? Tomoe-kun too? Tomoe-kun too? Are you feeling nervous too? Hard to bear. How desperate Ryu is very clear. Although she's trying her best to keep smiling, even though she looks like she is smiling, she's already crying. Tell that much. Ryu, listen to me. I don't want to. Please. Stop me from speaking again. I think about chatting her down, but Ryu's voice is so soft, yet so loud and clear. It silences me. I always thought that I don't want to lose. Don't want to hand you over. That I don't want to lose Oni-chan. I've known for a very long time who Oni-chan's had her eyes on. Even though I knew, came to fall in love with you. Even though I knew about Oni-chan's feelings, talked to her for advice about you. At first she looked at me surprised, but right away she smiled and told me just to leave it to her. I did something really mean, even though I knew that's the kind of person she is. Even though I knew that if I went to her for advice, Oni-chan would hold her back, own feelings, and help me. Even though I knew that, I went to ask her. As if to repent for what she'd done, she bites strongly into her lip. Even now, she's looking at me very nervously while on the brink of tears. I know it's cowardly and mean, but even so, I wanted to be with you, Tomoe-kun. Can't I? Why not do an Oni-chan's stead? Ryu. I'll become more like Oni-chan. I make myself able to talk about a lot more things. After all, we're twins. That's wrong. You said so yourself, Tomoe-kun. Said we're twins. I have the potential to be like that too. I can become more like Oni-chan. That's wrong. I'll do my best. I'll grow my hair out. I'll practice cooking very hard. If there's anything that I'm not doing well, please tell me. I'll do my best. I'll become the kind of girl that you desire, Tomoe-kun. Oh, please, Roni-chan. That's wrong. I love you, Tomoe-kun. I want to be with you. Hard to bear. Hearing her make me start hating myself. I wonder how I look to her in her teary eyes. How does she see me right now? Why am I driving a girl who is so bent on expressing her love to me into a corner like this? If it's Ryu, wouldn't she stay with me no matter what? If I break up with Ryu here, can I say for sure that Q would want to be with me? Isn't it more likely that I'll lose both of them? In that case, isn't staying like this okay? A white hand grabs me, my uniform near my chest. With a slight force, it pulls me over. My body falls toward Ryu. Tomoe-kun, Rice is getting closer. Quietly closes her eyes, waiting for me. I've seen this expression many times before. This expression that chose only to me. My will wavers. If I follow Ryu's lead, we can continue along the path. These past few weeks, setups down. With her, everything will go well. She, Ryu wouldn't betray. I stop moving my face forward, bite on my lip hard, grab Ryu's shoulders. Tomoe-kun? No. Eh? This isn't going to do. Tomoe-kun? Ryu, I... Can I get any words out of my mouth? A pair of eyes filled both tears and fear looking at me. I have to say it. If I don't say it here, it'll hurt her all the more. Even though I know... How come the words won't come out? Ryu shakes my hands off and runs out of the classroom. Ryu! Yell her name, my eyes begin to burn. I want to run after her, my legs won't not move. Even supposing that I'm a magic catcher, I can't get the words out. I'm so pathetic. Even though I made up my mind, I kept thinking of excuses to keep myself clean. Even then, without having said anything, Ryu's left with a deep, painful wound. On the wall and very hard. Because I'll not be able to stand back up without making myself feel pain. I hit it once again. The hot, blunt pain travels through my body. Never thought I'd be such a pathetic person. Really, I'm horrible. Pain torments me so much, my heart starts to creak. Whenever I close my eyes, even now, I can still see the image of Ryu. She was about to cry. In addition, my ears ring and add to the pressure. Feels as if I'm seeing a feverish nightmare. A sense of discomfort swirls inside my head. The next Q's face appears. Looks heartbroken. Even now, she looks as if she's on the verge of tears. Staring at me with eyes filled with reproach. Repeatedly, the two faces alternately flash inside my mind, and finally the sleepless night comes to an end. Each of them, my footsteps feel. I wonder what I'm walking down this path for. Where am I going? Having blended into the crowd of the students wearing the same uniform, I aimlessly walking in the same direction. Step by step, closer, I get closer and closer to school. Same time, my mood is souring bit by bit. The closer I get to school, the higher the chance I run into them. When I walk into the classroom, it is certain that I'll run into Ryu. Don't know what to say to her, and if she smiles at me, I won't be able to say a thing either. I'm so pathetic. I come to realize that as I walk, the distance between each of my steps are much shorter than usual. During class, there's a teacher voice and the voice of my classmates answering questions after being called on. I listen to those voices, I lay down on my arm, and usually the ringing that here in the ear at night is now easier to bear, but when Ryu delivers her answer being called on, and her voice reaches my ear, my hazy consciousness is forcefully awakened. My forehead still buried in my arm, without changing my posture, I open my eyelids. I just stare at the wooden texture of my desk In the dimly lit environment below my head and arms, I hear her voice, a bit in full. No matter what she's actually saying now, her voice sounds as if she is reproaching me. I know that there isn't no way Ryu would do something like that. Even so, the sense of guilt in me is driving me to think that way. I've discovered how much of a weakling I am. It's almost shocked me. Classes have ended, there's only homeroom to go before school's out. I've already left classroom. I feel that if we end up going home at the same time, then I'd be obligated to talk to her. I was so terrified of the thought that she might be perhaps coming up to me herself. So I ditched homeroom and left classroom first. I'm such a coward that I believe. Perhaps if I just keep running away, it'll all naturally come to an end. I sigh at myself for thinking that way and take a sip of bitter coffee. So, what are you doing in my room? Hey, welcome back. I'm home? Don't welcome back me. You weren't there during homeroom, weren't you? It's just homeroom. Doesn't it really matter if I was there or not, does it? Of course it matters. You were there during fourth period, but not homeroom? Who would have thought? We all figured you went to the restroom and waited for you to come back. I see. Thanks to you, homeroom was extended and we all got out late. Sorry about that. Since Ryu-chan's the class president, she went looking everywhere for you, you know. I see. What? So? Did you settle things after school yesterday? Settle what? You managed to catch her alone, no? Did you tell her that you're breaking up with her? I couldn't say it. Thought so. You're pretty kind in the strangest place, you know that? That's the shortcoming. In this case, the personality only makes things more painful. Feel like your wounds keep being reopened? So in the end, what are you going to do? Just keep going out with Ryu-chan like this? Well, if I were you, I would've been okay with either one. All that aside, maybe I should go after Q. Since she's grieving, she'll probably go easy to score. If it goes well, I'll be your older brother. Ow, since when is English to have dictionary used for hitting people? Since you don't use it that much, it feels just as hard as brand new, doesn't it? The way you're jabbing back is really similar to Q. If it irritates you that much, then hurry up and break up with Ryu. Now I'll go after Ryu-chan. If it goes well, he'll be my older brother. Ah, the corner! It hurts! Keep it down, will you? The voice, it's a rugby club. Open the door, I'll beat you in your head. Respect the communal life. Don't open the door, he's really going to beat me up. Sound stuff. Hey, what are you opening it? Rugby club member squeezes in through the gap. Alright, which one of you is howling? That guy over there. Snore points straight at me. Rugby club member glares at me. Silently, I lightly point at Tsunahara's direction. Come here. Hey, why me? It's like that Tsunahara gets dragged away. Seeing that, I clap my hands together and bow. Oh, hey. You Okazaki, right? Yeah, and? Ryu's looking for you. Which? That was probably the younger one. I see, thanks. Now you come this way. Wow, the rugby guy is so nice. Help! Oh. Having taken a blow of his stomach, Tsunahara starts moving, and the guy then lifts him over his shoulder and leaves the room. All by himself, I sigh. Ryu's looking for me. Guess I am going to have to go. Guess I have to. I can't keep putting it off. To break it to her clearly. Tell her that I can't be with her anymore. Happen after for now. But if she does what she did yesterday, then I'll go see her. Can't keep going on like this. If things stay that way they are, they'll end up hurting Ryu even more. And those words would never heal. Wounds will never heal, no matter. No rather, they would keep hurting her. As long as I don't make it clear out to her. As long as by me, it'll just keep hurting her. I'm really thinking for her. If I'm really thinking that even it means she would despise me for it. I'll have to turn her wounds into ones that can at least heal. That's the only thing I can do. And sometimes that I have to do. She thought of me as indispensable. She gave me, who was all alone, a place where my mind was at ease. I never felt that happy before. If it was with her, if it was with Ryu, it'd all go well. I truly thought so. But I noticed another girl who had her eyes fixed on me and the feeling she held behind her gaze. I noticed how I truly felt myself, and I must not ignore that. I take out the small bag that had been lying inside my school bag the whole time. Take the pendant with the purple gemstone that I bought the day before my date with Ryu. This is the one that Q wanted. Instead of what Ryu wanted, this is the one that I remembered. I'm walking inside the school building by myself. Ryu's probably still inside the school. I walk all over. First place to try is my own classroom. Then the courtyard. Then the cafeteria. The schoolyard. The front yard. Continue my search starting from the first floor. Then the second year's classrooms. And the third year's. I wonder how many times I come to these places. I wonder how many times I've gone up and down these stairs. When I see a girl with a similar hairstyle as hers, I chase after them. Keep glancing through the windows in the hallways and classrooms. I'm searching for Ryu, while I reminisce about the memories we had made together. A smile begins to appear in my mind. Then her flushing red face when she's embarrassed. Her serious face when she's telling fortunes. Lastly, her sorrowful, heartbroken face. Shake my head. I let my emotions get the better of me here. It'll end up just like yesterday. I have to be clear to her about who it is that I like and that I can no longer be with her. Gradually, the sun hangs lower and lower, stretching out the shadow of the ground. Linoleum flooring of the hallways also dyed crimson by the sunset. I wonder why red, a color that's supposed to be lively and intense, becomes so melancholic on occasions like this. I rub my knees, which are trembling from exhaustion, while I lean against the wall. Still haven't found her. Is she really still here in the school? I let out a sigh. Big deep sigh reflecting my exhaustion. The moment I look outside the window, it feels as if my blood has frozen. Crimson tinted courtyard stands. There stands somebody. Her hair fluttering among the wind. I recognize that. Ryu. My legs move as I'm too exhausted. Not exhausted at all. I run down the hallway. Although I know that's what awaits me will only be painful, I keep speeding forward. In order to bid farewell, I run there. The breeze is strong, and the red tinted scenery cold wind strikes my body. Just the leaves around this rustle among the wind. The wind blows as if it's enveloping me, as if it is slipping past my body, as if it's freezing my heart. We stand still among the wind. Without exchanging word, all we do is stand there and look at each other, as if we're trying to get good look at our own faces reflected in each other's sorrowful eyes. Same time, I can feel it. Resolve. Ryu? Call her name. Seemingly frightened, she bites her lips as her small shoulder tremble lightly. Saying that, my composure suddenly slips. The words that I just must say are stuck in my throat. Try closing my eyes. I recall each and every moment I spent with Ryu. What she looked like as she told my fortune. How she quickly ran away without her face turned red. After her face turned red. When we sat and ate lunch next to each other. Two of us spent our day off around town. Came to know what warmth feels like. It all feels so fresh, yet so nostalgic. The last 3 weeks have been really fun. As I gently open my eyes, I start talking to her. She taught me how good it feels to be needed by someone. Everything that I saw, everything that I heard, all that time we spent every day felt so new. Really. Been really fun. I thought it'd be great if it kept going forever. No, rather, I thought we could keep it going forever. I thought I could do well together with you, but I came to notice Through you, I notice who I had my eye. I know what I'm doing is truly terrible. I was foiled. Foiled by how gentle you are and kept dragging it out. All that time we spent together only served to hurt you. What I've done is mean and not fair, because I didn't make it clear to you. You were hurt. While I was with you, looking at you, words get stuck in my throat. Most important thing, the one thing I had out of my mouth. My lips tremble. I had to say it right now to bring this to an end. Ryu, I'm sorry. Person I like is your sister. Ryu trembles. Bites hard at her lips and red of tears she looks at me. I like you. Suddenly, I feel a powerful impact on my chest. Briny sensations spread through my mouth. Something wet and soft is pressing against my lips. For a moment, I can't figure out what's going on. Right in front of my eyes is a face laden with tears. Her eyes are tightly shut, causing tears to drip out and onto our overlapping lips. I can feel that there are strong, powerful feelings hidden in the kiss. Taste is simply sad. We can't. Pull my face back and turn away. Ryu, stop. Her hands reach around my neck and forcefully turn my head forward again. Kisses once again, hugging me with all even, as if she's thrusting her feelings at me. Even so, I turn away. I dread the kiss that tastes of tears. Ryu, we can't do this. It's Q whom I like. It's your sister. Every time I look at you, my head is only filled with Q. That's how truly terrible I am. Even if we stay together, it'll only hurt you. That's why. Moya, called by my name. Squeezed her lips on mine once again. My mind turned blank. What did she just say now? What did she call me? Whose voice was that? Gently, the warm sensation leaves my lips. Finally, I can clear her tear-sodden face. I love you. Don't tell me you're. I love you, Tomoya. Q? Wait, huh? What? What's up with your hair? Don't run away. Ryu told me. Don't run away. Ryu did tell me that if I actually liked you, that mustn't run away. She was mad at me. Miles, seemingly troubled, yet happy. She said she's sorry to you. Also to me. Terrible. That she only thought for herself and her, the two of us. That she did nothing but bespoiled her by her gentleness. And that she made things so difficult for us. No. I'm the one who made things difficult. It was me who was spoiled and hurt everyone. I was so fixated on something, on staying where I felt comfortable, I didn't consider either of your feelings, and brought you to such painful memories. It's me who's terrible and underhanded. No. Actually, none of us are. Nothing that's good or bad. I realized that when the two of us fell in love with the same person, one of us was going to be hurt. That's why I thought I would try to bear it if it meant Ryu could keep smiling. I thought that was better than her confessing to you and getting rejected. I thought I could bear it better than the pain of being rejected. But it was no good. I couldn't keep going forward while saying no to my own feelings. Not only that, I couldn't even stay where I was and chose to run away. I felt depressed. And then Ryu got mad at me. Told me that I can't run away. Said that if I were to feel down, I should feel down for getting rejected. Said that she could cry with me. That happens. Ryu was almost tearing up, but she still said that with a smile. That's why I can't anymore. Q. Tomoya. Q firmly closes her eyes, as if she's hesitating. As if she's resisting. She slowly breathes in and slowly breathes out. Opens her eyes. Then, with a strong will behind her eyes, she looks at me. I love you. I've always loved you, Moya. Her tent look, filled with her feeling, pierces through me. I feel something warm suddenly strike my heart and spread through my body. I take the small package with the pendant out of my pocket and hand it to Q. I bought this for you, but I got the gemstone wrong. I can only remember the one you wanted. Now that I think about it, I might have already made my decision back then. So absurd, seriously. Moya. But if you don't mind me being like this, I want to be there next to you. No. Guess I can't. I just had to say that wrong. I love you. Let me stay by your side. Tamoya. She draws her body to me and hugs me. Close my eyes as well and hug her back. So I don't let go of our very first step of our journey together as lovers. So that I don't let go of those warmth very firmly and strongly. I hug her. Guess that was it for Q's Path, huh? That was... what a ride. What a roller coaster. Oh my god. It always seems like these stories leave me needs to be true here. That I didn't expect to Q to cut her hair off there and pretend to be Ryu, but I guess what they both knew, huh? But, oh, jeez. Only Tamoya here. I can't think of anything to say. The words aren't coming out. What the fuck? That was... damn. Poor Ryu. She's trying her hardest. And even though it was only less than a month, it felt like so long. Oh my god. That went longer than I thought I was gonna go. That was way longer than I thought it was gonna be. Oh my gosh. Wow. That was just a shitty situation and for everyone, honestly. Are we gonna get an aftermath story here? Nothing? Oh, here we go. Inside the Sunset Soul classroom, I'm standing next to the window, calming myself down. Something I have to do. If I run away from this, I won't be able to go further to tell her. Otherwise, I would only continue to be a coward. Turning the classroom, just hearing the sound, I turn around. Hey. Tamoya-kun, I wonder how many days it's been since we faced each other like this. Ever since I started going out with Q, I haven't been able to look her straight in the eye. I suppose it's also the same for her. Until today, we have not talked to each other at all. Back from the school committee? How'd it go? Yeah, it wasn't bad. I see. Are you waiting for Oni-chan? If that's the case, I think she'll be back to her own classroom soon. I was waiting for you instead, Ryu. Me? And nod, causing Ryu to stiffen up a little. Gently I take a deep breath, and I lower my head deeply. Sorry. Tamoya-kun. I was spoiled by how gentle you are. You kept doing things that only ended up hurting you. It's not something I deserve to be forgiven for, even if I apologize, but I'm sorry. My head's still hanging down, I say. Plan on taking in whatever the blame she lays on me. I wouldn't even mind if she hits me, but I had to apologize. No. Her words grip my heart. Even so, my head remains down, because there's nothing I can do but to apologize. This is the beginning. I don't want to forgive you, so please, don't apologize. If you apologize, it makes me want to forgive you. Feeling a sense of calmness from her tone, I lift my head up without a thought. I really enjoyed the time I spent together with you, Tomoe-kun. We went to so many different places. We had lunch together, just the two of us. You bought me a pendant. We also kissed. You gave me so many memories. You apologize. I forgive you. It makes me feel that the time we spent together was a lie. They are all very precious to me. So please, don't apologize. Yeah, I see. If I apologize like this, then this would only be self-satisfaction. I actually have ended with me hurting her. Ryu. Yes? Thanks. Yes. Tomoe-kun, I'd like to thank you too. Ryu says and lightly bows her head toward me. Once again, I lower my head. Instead of saying something as backwards as sorry, we should bring this to an end in anticipation of what's to come. Right now, we go back to being friends again. The spirit came to an end. Summer's come and gone. Cool breezes return to the air. It is fall. A season where a sense of loneliness floats through the air. What's up? What do you mean? Weren't you staring at me just now? No, it's nothing. Just thinking your hair's getting longer. Oh, my hair? It was nice and long before. It's such a waste. Well, I got to find out how you truly feel, so I guess it was worth it. What do you mean by that? Whether you had changed the heart when it was Ryu in front of you. Actually, you can tell that I wasn't Ryu just because I cut my hair short. Something to think about. All that, thinking about it now, I've calm down, that comes as quite a shock. You, I love you. Yeah, I know. That aside, don't mistake that girl you love for someone else. I didn't dodge that one. Hell, I dug myself a deeper hole instead. Well, I fell in love with you knowing that kind of guy you are. What do you mean by that's the kind of guy you are? An impulsive idiot who doesn't think things over. That's not much of a compliment. Really? I don't think so. At the very least, I don't feel very happy hearing that. You work very hard with all your might toward a single objective. Especially someone that's for someone else. Back then, you put so much thought into how not to hurt Ryu any further. You probably didn't even think about yourself or about me. About me. What's the matter? Somehow that kind of gets me on my nerves a little. Don't say something so disturbing. At least say I'm feeling envious. It's okay, isn't it? Since that annoyed me, it just means that I still like you. Well, I guess. By the way, did you know Ryu got herself a boyfriend? Really? Yeah, it's a boy she met at the hospital she's working out. He has a pretty cute face, you know? Ryu got a boyfriend, huh? Why, are you feeling all jealous now? Saying I'm jealous a little too much, but well, it feels kinda complicated. Hey, Tomoya. Are you really okay with me? Don't you think you were more comfortable being with Ryu instead? You know, I'm getting mad. Yeah, get mad. If you get mad at me, I'll know you still love me, alright? Moron. Well, that's mean. You just call your girlfriend a moron? Don't care about verifying other people's feelings using silly methods like that. Come on, jealousy's just like the emotion that showcases these things in the clearest. Says with a slight sulky look. As I look at Kyu acting like that, I let out a sigh. Everything is so convoluted with you. Well then, want to use a much easier method? What? The moment I lift my face up, something hits my lips. It's warm and soft. And right in front of me, I see Kyu's face. Kyu takes her lips off, mischievously smiles with a slightly brushing face. Not out in public again. You don't hate it, right? What'd you do if you others see us doing that? I guess I'd feel a little embarrassed. Just a little. In that case, we can do lots if it's somewhere without people. Doesn't sound like it'd just be kissing if we did that. About that, well, what should I say? If this is really somewhere people without people, sounds good. Hey, what's with that brisk, refreshing smile? Good response, isn't it? That aside, you sounded so lewd. You're imagining some things. You absolutely did. Oh, look who's here to meet us. Yeah, oh, Botan. Guess we're taking him on a walk. Seems so. There, stop clinging to my leg. There. Thought I'd let my hair grow out, and the longer it grows, the more you'll love me. I love you plenty right now. I want you to love me even more. So I have to grow it out quickly. Don't have to rush yourself. Nope. I'll grow it out quickly. I see, well, good luck. Tomoya, what's up? I love you, okay? Looks like we completed another path here today that honestly took way longer than I thought it would, but yeah, look at that. Huh. God. The more I do this, the more I just fall in love with this visual. It's just so good. Look at this. Look at... Oh my god. That was way longer than I thought it was going to be. Like... What day did we finish on? What day was that? I don't even remember. But the last choice we made was... May 7th. When we called out to her. When she was about to confess to Sunohara. That was the last time that was the last choice we had there. So just imagine that. Just think of how much we went through. Also think about how many hours it took. It's like around like over 5 hours right now, I think. God, oh my god. I can't think of anything to say. But there's also about an hour of recording this is about 100 gigabytes. So just put that in perspective for how long. So about 600 gigabytes has been used in the last few hours. I think we need to cut it off here. And, hope you guys all enjoyed as much as I have. And the next part will continue on in a different route. So I hope you guys all enjoyed. I said it at the end. I'll see you guys then. Goodbye.